Hello students, today I'll explain you the next unit in grammar, subject verb conquered or agreement of the verb with the subject. So children, let's start with the subject. Subject means a person or thing about which something is said. Subject has a great importance in a sentence. Subject can be of two types. Singular and plural. So let's see what kind of singular subjects are possible. A singular subject can be he, she, it, I, you. I have underlined you because you is treated as plural. Ravi, my mother or my father, my friend, his sister, her aunt, Mr. Singh, etc. So children, you must have seen in all these subjects, what is common is their number. Means they are one in number. He refers to a boy or a man. She refers to a girl or a woman. It refers to a thing or an animal. Now let's see the plural form of the subject. We, they, you, my parents, his cousins, their relatives, our friends, teachers, our elders, etc. Everything that is more than one is a plural subject. Now we'll see two types of verbs, singular verbs and plural verbs. Let's see what are singular verbs. Singular verbs are those verbs which are used with singular subjects, such as is, was, has, does, did and had. Although did and had are used both with singular as well as plural subjects. Apart from these verbs, we have main verbs also, and when we use them with singular subjects, we use them with s or es, with the main plain verb, such as plays, goes, gives, knows, etc. Now let's see the plural verbs. Plural verbs are those verbs which are used with plural subjects. For example, are, were, have, do, had, did. So, as I told you children, did and had are used both with singular subjects as well as with plural subjects. Now, the main verbs which are used with plural subjects are play, go, give, no, etc. You must have noticed that we have not used s or es with these verbs. They are the plain form of first form of verbs. So in this children, now you have learned that what is subject verb conquered or subject verb agreement. Now this agreement is also called relationship, because with singular subjects we use only the singular verbs. With plural subjects, we use only the plural verbs. And if we do not do this, the sentence will not make any sense. To make a sentence meaningful, we have to use them properly. This is called subject verb conquered. Now, there are certain rules of subject verb relationship or agreement. Let's see what those rules are. Rule number one, a singular subject takes the verb in the singular and a plural subject takes the verb in the plural. As I told you in the beginning, that with a singular subject, we will use a singular verb, and with a plural subject, we will use a plural verb. Now, one thing which must be remembered is that all English verbs are plural, because I told you that we have pure verbs like play, go, write, swim, jump, eat, all these are plural verbs. And to make them singular, we add s or es to them. So, we must remember this point that all English verbs are plural. We make them singular by adding s or es to the verb. Now, we'll understand rule number one with these examples. Sohan comes here every week. Because Sohan is a singular subject, it takes a singular verb, that is comes. The teachers are on strike. Teachers is a plural subject and are is a plural verb, as I told you in the beginning. So with this, rule number one is easily understood. Now we have rule number two. Rule number two is, when two or more singular subjects are connected by and, the verb should be in plural. Like, Ram and Shyam are my cousins. So, Ram and Shyam. It means whenever two subjects are connected by and, it means a plural subject. So, we should take a plural verb with such kind of subjects. Example, Sohan and Ravi are brothers. So, because Sohan is a singular subject, Ravi is a singular, but both together, when they are connected by and, give a plural sense of subject. So, they will take a plural verb such as are. The third rule is, when two singular nouns refer to the same person, the verb must be in singular. When two nouns tell something about a same person or a thing, it means it is a singular subject. So, in that case, we'll take a singular verb. For example, Shruti's friend and colleague is coming. So, the person who is coming is same. He is or she is Shruti's friend as well as her colleague. So both are same person. Same person means singular subject. So we'll take a singular verb with singular subject. The manager and secretary. So the manager is the same person and the secretary is the same person himself. Has died. We have used has over here because it refers to single man who was the manager as well as the secretary. So it will take a singular verb. Fourth rule is, when two or more nouns make one unit, the verb must be in singular. Means, when two nouns, the names of two nouns are different, but they both together make up one singular thing, then they will take a singular verb. For example, rice and curry is my favorite dish. So we will not say rice and curry are, because rice is eaten mixed up with curry. So it makes one single dish. So rice and curry is my favorite dish. If we say rice and curry are my favorite, so it will be wrong. Bread and butter is perfect food. So when butter is applied on bread, then it makes it a perfect food. So both bread and butter make a single unit, that is one singular subject, which will take a singular verb. Now we'll see the fifth rule. When a singular subject is qualified by each or every, the verb must be in singular, because each and every are used before a singular subject. So that the rule says that when they are qualified by each or every, then the verb must be in singular, because it tells that these and the subject is singular. For example, each boy was given a present. Suppose there are 10 boys in the group and every boy was given a gift, means each boy was. Each refers to every single boy. So when each is there, we will use a singular verb with singular subject. Another example is, every girl has a book of her own. For example, there are 20 girls in the class and every girl has a book of her own. Every refers to each and every single girl. So, when boy and girl, these nouns are qualified by each and every, they will take a singular verb. Next rule is, the phrase one of is always followed by a plural noun, but the verb is always singular. The phrase one of is always followed by a plural noun. Try to understand this thing. The phrase one of is always followed by a plural noun means after one of, the noun which we will use will always be plural. For example, one of the boys, one of the books. This is the very book that I needed. But the verb which will be used with them will always be singular. For example, one of the boys. Boys is plural. But because we have used one of before it, we will take a singular verb here. One of the books. The books is plural. But because it is preceded by one of, this kind of a subject will always take singular verb. One of the boys sings very well. One of the books is mine, because we are talking about one of all the boys. One book of all the books. This is the very book that I needed. This is the very book means this is the same book that I needed. Now, next rule is, when two nouns are linked by either or neither nor, the verb agrees with the later noun or nouns. For example, neither food nor clothes were available. Neither the boys nor the teacher is here. So, we are talking about food, neither food nor clothes. Two nouns are there. We have used were here because it is clothes. See the second example. Neither the boys nor the teacher is here. The verb agrees with the later one because the later one, this is the later one. It is a plural verb, plural subject. So we will take a plural verb. Teacher is a singular subject, so we'll take a singular verb. So neither food nor clothes. When such kind of nouns in which one is singular and other is plural, they are separated by neither nor, so the verb which will be used over here will agree with the later noun, which is a plural one. And in the second case, when two nouns like boys and teacher are separated by neither nor, we will take a verb which will agree to the later noun, that is not boys but teacher, which is a singular one, so we'll take a singular noun. This is rule number 7. Now let's come and see rule number 8. When a sentence begins with introductory there, the verb should agree with the noun that follows it. I'll repeat. When a sentence begins with introductory there, let's see. There are 6 boys in the class. There is a table in my room. The verb should agree with the noun that follows. When a sentence starts with there, see both these examples, both the sentences are starting with there. But in both the sentences, we have used different verb. In the first sentence, we have used a plural verb. And in the second sentence, we have taken a singular verb. Why? Because this verb is followed by a plural subject. Listen very carefully. This verb is followed by a plural subject. Six boys. That is why we have used a plural verb over here after there. But in the second case, the sentence although starts with there but takes a plural verb because it is followed by, singular verb, because it is followed by a singular subject, a table. So in both the cases, what is the difference? The difference is of the subject. Singular plural subject, plural verb. Singular subject, singular verb. But both are starting with there. So I'll repeat this point. When a sentence begins with introductory there, the verb should agree with the noun that follows. So the verb which we will take must agree with the noun which is following it. Now we come to rule number 9. The nouns connected with, together with, as well as, take the verb according to the former noun. I'll repeat. Nouns connected by, with, together with, or as well as. For example, the mother with her children goes to work. The father, as well as my mother, has come. So all these words are joining or connecting two subjects. Mother and her children are connected by with. The father and my mother are connected by as well as. So what kind of a verb they will take? Take the verb according to the former noun, not the later. Like in previous case, we took a verb according to the later noun, according to the noun that was following this verb. But in this, because we have two nouns, the verb will go in agreement with the noun which is later, not the former one. So my mother, in this case, it will go with the former one. So my mother, because mother is singular, we'll take goes. The father, singular, we'll take has. Although the next noun, the later noun, is the children, which is plural. My mother is also a singular one, but we'll go with the former noun.